So hello guys, welcome back. So in today's video, I'm going to talk about the types of displacement sensor. Okay, actually in today's video, I'm going to present with you guys two displacement sensor, which is capacitive sensor, and also is another one is Hall effect sensor. So let's take a look on the first one, which is the capacitive sensor. Alright, this is a capacitive sensor. It is basically a sensing device. So this is the diagram of how the capacitive sensor actually looks like in the real world. So let's take a look about the working principles or operation of capacitive sensor. So how does it work? So basically, a metal plate in the sensing phase of the sensor is electrically connected to an internal oscillator circuit, which means here that inside the capacitive sensor, there lies actually an internal oscillator circuit. So the external capacitance between the target and the internal sensor plate forms a part of the feedback capacitance in the oscillator circuit. As the target approaches the sensor phase, the oscillations increase until they reach a threshold level and activate the output. So what does it mean by this working principle? So how does it work is that basically if you take this device and you kind of put close to an object, for example, you take the device and put it like close to the table or maybe like metal surfaces, it actually detects the signal, and the signal is converted into frequency, okay, and there will be a reading there from the capacitance device. Okay, you guys can see this capacitance sensor. Okay, one of the applications are your own handphones or smartphones. Okay, so this is an example of a capacitance sensor. Okay, it works as a sensor, and because it's called capacitance, it means that it detects charges. Okay, for example, when you are using your phone, it actually uses a capacitor, and your thumb is actually a positive charge and your phone is a negative charge. So basically, if you move your thumb to the left or to the right, it detects that position, the change of position of your thumb. And so the screen also follows wherever you touch. For example, you are scrolling through social media. So basically, the sensor detects your arm going from left to right or maybe from up to down. And from there, the charges from the capacitance follows your thumb. That is why capacitance sensor is very important, especially during the age of technology, because we use it very frequently during these times. Okay, so what are the advantages and disadvantages? The advantages, it has high sensitivity and operates at minimum force. It means that you are able to touch your smartphone without like you apply too much pressure. It means it actually detects your thumb, okay, by using the charges, the positive charges and the negative charges. And the next thing is it has simple construction. It means that it doesn't need a sophisticated device in order to detect, okay, the displacement of your thumb. For example, you are scrolling through social media, it doesn't need something big, okay, in order to detect, and it is very small. Okay, it can fit inside our smartphones, and that is why we say it has simple construction. The next thing is disadvantages. So what are the disadvantages? The first one, it reacts to temperature and pressure easily. Yeah, we talk about that we only need a small amount of pressure. Yeah, that is true. But if you apply too much pressure, it will damage the device, or maybe it cannot detect the displacement of your position of apa thumb, things like that. And temperature is yes, because it is made out of electrical circuit, so it is very sensitive to increase of temperature. Okay, and the next one is less accurate than other type of sensors. Yes, there are other sensors that are more accurate, but we are not going to talk about it in this presentation because maybe in other kinds of device they use civil construction, but they are more accurate. So it means that they are able to detect a lot of things when you move your thumb. Okay, the next thing we are going to talk about Hall effect sensor. So what is it about Hall effect sensor? So Hall effect sensor, this is the diagram of the Hall effect sensor. So basically you have a permanent magnet and you have a Hall effect sensor. So this is the trigger wheel. So how does it work is that if you move the trigger wheel, okay, since there is a magnet detects change in magnetic flux or maybe a change in movement if the object is of course metal. But if the object is not metal, then it is a bit difficult to detect. That is why it is named Hall effect. Hall effect is something that has to got to do with the phenomenon in the change of magnetic flux, and we're going to talk about that in the next slide. So how does it work, the working principle? Okay, the first thing, when an electric current moves through the sensor, the electrons move through in a straight line. Okay, when an external magnetic field acts on the sensor, the Lorentz force deviates the charged carriers to follow a curved path. Due to this, the negative charge electrons will deflect towards one side of the sensor and the positive charge holes to another. Due to this accumulation of electrons and holes at different sides of the plate, a voltage can be observed between sides of the plate. So basically, is that when we connect something through through a circuit, okay, when we on the circuit, normally electrons will flow according to the circuit, right? So this cause change if you put a permanent magnet, okay, you apply on top of the circuit. So when you apply on top of the circuit, what will happen to the electron is that there is some turbulence or there are some disturbance in the electrons movement. So the movement of electrons will change or deviate to the side of the what you call it, to the side of the sensor. Okay, and this itself causes a change, not a change, it causes a potential difference. Okay, and it can be observed between the sides of the plate. So what are the disadvantages and the advantages? The first thing is that they are highly reliable. The second thing is they offer high speed operation. The third thing, the ability to work in wide temperature range. So it means that even in increase in temperature, they are able to work in different temperature, maybe cold temperature like -5 degrees, or maybe in high temperatures they are able to work as smoothly as possible. The second thing is the disadvantages, okay, which is not capable of measuring a current flow at a distance greater than 10 centimeter. It means that if you want to measure, okay, using this device, it cannot be greater than 10 centimeter because it will not detect the change, whatever change is happening, okay, the measurement could not detect. So this is the advantages, okay, because we would want something that could measure at maybe like longer distance or maybe longer length, you know, but this device itself has disadvantages, which is they can only measure less than 10 centimeter. The second thing is accuracy of the measured value is always concerned as external magnetic fields may affect the values. Yes, this is true because they are using magnetic field, okay, magnetic field, so it can be greatly affected, okay. Like for example, the magnetic field could change when you are measuring that device, and this is very hard to determine the accurate value of of the object. For example, you are measuring the triggering wheel just now I was talking about. So it's kind of hard because, you know, it is involved in magnetic field. So it is going to be hard because there's always having change. And also one thing is because we put permanent magnet, okay, and that applies to Lorentz law. So that's it, guys. If you have any question, you could ask me about the presentation or the subject or anything. You could just leave a comment below if you think you have an additional knowledge that you could add. And thanks for watching for this video, and I'll see you in the next future videos. Thank you and bye bye.